Hello, my dear students. A very good morning to one and all. How are you all, my students? Hope all are fit and fine and staying at home, doing their work, helping their parents. So, dear students, as you can observe, we are going to continue our previous session. In that session, we have discussed about the topic determiners. So, we are going to continue the same. Determiners. Uses of following determiners. Sum refers to a quantity of people or things whose number is not specified. We use sum to express quantity or number in positive statements. I'm repeating the same. We use sum to express quantity or number in positive statements. Keep it in your mind. For example, I need some help. Whereas, any is a quantifier which signifies quantity of a noun but not in exact terms. Any is used to express number or quantity in negative statements. As you have read earlier that sum is used to express number or quantity in positive statements, whereas any is used to express number or quantity in negative statements. For example, there was not any help available. So, dear students, some more points we have to follow while using the determiner sum or any. Sum is used with both countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Countable nouns and uncountable nouns. You already know the concept of countable and uncountable nouns. Countable nouns are those which can be counted. Uncountable nouns are those which cannot be counted. Sum is used in positive sentences. Sum is also used in questions when we are making a request. Whereas, any is used in negative sentences. Any is used in questions. In questions, both determiners, sum and any, are acceptable. We use sum if we expect a positive answer. We use sum if we expect a positive answer. And any if a negative answer is expected. For example, do you have any complaints? Do you have any complaints? Here, the answer expected is no. Do you need some more? Here, the answer expected is yes. Continuing the determiners topic, the next determiner is a. The article a is also a determiner which is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant sound. For example, a banana, a bird, a cycle, a dog, a cat, etc. I'm repeating, the article a is also a determiner which is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant sound. Dear students, you already know that what are vowel sounds and what are consonant sounds. I'm repeating the same, what are vowel sound or consonant sounds. Vowels, there are five vowels. A, E, I, O, U. Similarly, the sounds beginning from the same vowels are vowel sound. A, E, I, O, U are vowel sound. Like ant. Ant word is starting from A sound. And A is a vowel. So, it is a vowel sound. And the remaining sounds are consonant sounds. Hope it is clear to all. Continuing to the next determiner, an. The article an is also a determiner which is used before a singular noun beginning with a vowel sound. As I have explained it, what are vowel sounds? A, E, I, O, U are vowels. The sounds beginning from the vowels are A, E, I, O, U are vowel sound. For example, an ant. Here, ant, you can observe it. The sound is starting from a vowel, so it is a vowel sound. So we have used an before and. An apple, an umbrella, an owl, an aisle. So you have observed these are vowel sounds. Apple, umbrella, owl, aisle. So these are vowel sounds and we have used an before vowel sounds. Hope it is cleared to everyone. What are vowel sounds, what are consonant sounds and the uses of some, any, a, an. Hope it is cleared to all. Thank you. Keep studying. Keep supporting. Take care.